पंढरीनाथ महाराज की
जय।
पंढरी क्षेत्र की
जय।
चंद्रभागा तीर्थ की
जय।
समस्त भक्त मंडली की
जय।
समस्त साधु मंडली की
जय।
समस्त सद्गुरुनाथ
ये Thank you. to get good placements, and after that placement We should get a handsome job and get married soon, so that we can start living in a family and we can start supporting that family. And as the days pass, wife or husband, whoever the case is, the spouse, and children depend on us. So we should earn. We should be the breadwinner of the family. We should support our family. And we think that supporting our family is always in terms of money. We constantly run behind something or the other. Our needs are insatiable. It keeps increasing day by day. We keep running behind something or the other day by day. But we fail to understand that we have to indulge ourselves in Bhagavad Karyam. If we think about money constantly, then we might not give our 100% for Bhagavad Chintana. But if we say, and if we understand the concept that money might come and go, we are least bothered about money, then when we require money, money will come to us. It might be a miracle. Someone out of somewhere will come to us and will give us money and will leave. That is none other than Bhagavan. But sometimes we fail to realize it. So we are like a person who says, "Oh Bhagavan, I can manage all these things. I can manage a certain area. You can manage the rest. You take care of those things which are adrishtam, which are not seen to me, which are not in my vicinity. So you take care of the rest." Bhagavan acts accordingly. He listens to his bhaktas. He is always obedient to his bhaktas. So he happily listens to him and says, "Okay, I will take care of your life to the extent to which you have permitted me." So he happily showers his blessing even then, but stands at a distance. Coming to the case of pure bhaktas, those who know nothing other than Bhagavan, they constantly think only about Bhagavan, Lord Shri Panduranga, and they know nothing in this world. They are not lured by money or fame or any other materialistic pleasure in this world. For those who have seen Panduranga, will they like something else? Will they want to go to something else and experience happiness? In Vanna Bhanga, Jnaneshwar Maharaj sings, "Sarva Sukha Che Agaru." All saints, all bhaktas and all sadhus have always kept their mind constantly upon Lord Panduranga only. They have not deviated at all. Ultimately, the result that they get is 0% concentration and attention towards materialistic life. They have come to this material world and somehow they have to live this also. So what does Bhagavan do? He says, Yoga Kshema Vahamyaham. I will come down. I will live your life for you. I will ensure that you have everything in life. I will ensure that everything goes properly in your life. Saying so, he comes down. He helps every single bhakta. This is not only for those who are constantly engaged in Nama Sankirtanam or Bhakti. We normal people can also experience Bhagavan's presence in our life in many cases. That is because he cannot see his children suffering. He is Bhakta Vatsal. He showers his blessing on everyone. So he protects everyone and he ensures that everyone gets everything that they ask for and they desire for. It might be spiritual aspirations or materialistic aspirations. Now the main point which Bhagavan Shri Krishna says is, Yoga Kshema Vahamyaham. I will give you yoga and kshema. But Ananyash Chintayanto Maam. You must keep thinking about me. You must always fix your mind upon me. You should not have any other thought in your mind. And this is the most difficult part. Because in Bhagavad Gita itself, it is told that the mind cannot be controlled that easily. It happens through abhyasa, practice. And what is the sadhanam? What is the tool to bring our mind under our control? Nama Sankirtanam. Our eyes might see something. Without our control, it might see something. Ears might hear something without our control. Our nose might smell something without our control. It happens naturally. But our mouth cannot speak anything on its own. Only if we give directions, it speaks. So this tongue is a double-edged sword. It has to be used for Bhagavad Nama and Bhagavad Guna. If we constantly use it for Bhagavad Nama, if we constantly use it for Nama Sankirtanam, then we become what we say. We become what we think. If we constantly keep telling something, this creates a positive vibration in us. This creates positive thinking in us. It creates positive thoughts in us. And this positive thought will ultimately lead us to Sattvika Bhavam. And this thought is nothing but Bhagavad Chintana, Hari Dhyana, Panduranga Dhyana. And we can attain ultimate bliss through Nama Sankirtana. In fact, this is the most easiest path to attain God. And this is the Kali Yuga Dharma. In Kali Yuga, if we have to attain God, it can be only through Nama Sankirtana. So, Sant Jnaneshwar Maharaj, in his Abhanga, praises the greatness of Nama Sankirtana. He sings, Vithala 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 Panduranga Vithala 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 Panduranga Vithala 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 Panduranga Vithala 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 Panduranga Vithala 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 Panduranga Vithala 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 Panduranga
Vithala 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 V Thank you.
chanting His Nama. Always keep chanting His names. Nama Sankirtana. Keep singing it. Always. Hari Mukhe Mana, Hari Mukhe Mana. Keep singing Hari Nama. Keep singing Krishna Nama. Keep singing Rama Nama. Keep singing Vithala Nama. Keep singing Panduranga Nama. And if you keep singing that, if you keep singing all these namas, Punyachi Ganana Kaundakari, you will get so much of Punya in your account that nobody will be able to measure it. It will be immeasurable, innumerable, uncountable. Nobody will be able to count it. They cannot even imagine. It is out of our imagination. We will get so much of Punya. Punyachi Ganana Kaundakari. In the other words, we'll get so much of blessings from Bhagavan that we'll not be able to measure it. Every day we will spend our life with Him. Every day becomes a miracle. So can we note it down? How many days can we note down? Everything becomes a leela. So Punyachi Ganana Kaundakari. Will someone measure it? Will someone be able to measure it? Or by chanting Harinama, will someone look at Punya? Will someone look at the Punya count that they have got? Will someone tally their Punya and Papa account? Will someone keep doing that? They have got something sweeter than that. Punya Papa is only for our Janana Marana cycle. But ultimately, it is not only Punya that will take us to Bhagavan. It is not Papa that will take us to Naraka. Both of these must be the a person might totally destroy all the papa that he has. He might burn all the papa that he has. Even then, if he has punya, that will also be as a hindrance for him to attain Bhagavan. So, punya papa is something which is in the lower strata. We need to start concentrating on something which is much more better and higher than punya papa. So punyachi ganana kaunakari, will someone keep calculating the punya that they've got? Instead they've got Hari Nama. They have Bhagavan itself. They will have Tene Mukti Chari Sadhi Elya. They will get all four types of mukti. They will get all four kinds of mukti very quickly by just chanting Bhagavan Nama. And that too, they did not do it meticulously. They need not prepare a chart and do it. Or they need not do it like big bhaktas, purest bhaktas like Prahlada, Dhruva, Draupadi or Gajendra. They can be very common. They can be a normal person. Devachiya Dwari Ubha Kshana Bhari. It is enough if you just stand in front of Devachiya Dwari, in front of the temple of Bhagavan. And it is enough if you just chant His Nama once. Kshana Bhari. You need not stand there the entire day. You need not stand there for an entire hour. You need not stand there for a minute. Just a second is enough. Devachiya Dwari Ubha Kshana Bhari. Even if you stand there for a minute and say Hari Nama, Hari Mukhe Mana, Hari Mukhe Mana, then Tene Mukti Chari Sadhi Elya. You will easily get all four kinds of mukti. What are the four kinds of mukti? Samlokyam, Samipyam, Sarupyam, Sayujyam. Samlokyam. Every person who has got mukti, if he has got Samlokya mukti, will get a chance to stay in Bhagavat Lokam. Let us imagine Bhagavan to be a king. He is heading everyone. He is the ultimate superior emperor whose crown and throne to rule the entire world. And now he might have a capital city. When we get a chance to stay in the capital city, it becomes Sa Lokyam. We get a chance to stay in Bhagavat Lokam. Sa Meepyam. Sa Meepyam is one step ahead of Salokyam because we will get a chance to stay in the same where he lives. Sa Nipya will be very close to him. Sa Rupya. Sometimes bhaktas are totally engrossed in bhakti to that extent where they get the form of Bhagavan. When someone looks at a person, if a true devotee looks at his Gurunatha, he will see Bhagavan only. In Vaikuntham, all the bhaktas who are there are mostly like Bhagavan itself. They have everything similar to that of Bhagavan. So this is Sarupyam. They act as brand ambassador of Bhagavan. They will be like Bhagavan itself. Sarupyam. Sayujyam. Not having another form, we will get united, immersed with Bhagavan. We will get together with Bhagavan. This is Sayujyam. So all these four kinds of mukti will be given to us that very second by just standing at the gate of Bhagavan's temple and chanting his holy name. There was a great devotee called Sant Chokameda. He stayed in Pandharipura. He was not allowed to get into the temple. So he stayed outside every day. But his mind was constantly fixed upon Panduranga. He kept chanting Vitthala Nama always. He kept chanting Panduranga Nama always, but he couldn't go into the temple. He stood at the gate of the temple. He stood at the dwaram, at the door, and he kept chanting Bhagavan Nama. One fine day, he was working in a construction site and the building collapsed. So Chokameda with other workers had to depart from their mortal body. Bhagavan couldn't tolerate it. So he ordered everyone to take the asti, bones or remains of Sant Chokameda from that place where the construction had collapsed. So they all went in, but they didn't know which one is Chokameda's bones. Bhagavan said, if you go there, you will understand. So they all went there. To their surprise, there were so many bones and remains, but only one set of bones or one set of remains kept singing. Vithala, 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 vithala. na barava to that extent where even if the skin goes, even if this flesh goes, even if this blood goes, his bones will start chanting his nama. And his bones will always keep chanting his nama. So in the same way, Sant Choka Mela's bones were singing Vithala nama. And they all took these bones with reverence. They placed it in front of Panduranga's temple and they erected a tomb there to pay their obeisances to the bhakti which Sant Choka Mela expressed. So, Devachiya Dwari Ubha Kshana Bhari. Even if you stay there for a second, you will get all that you wish for. You will get all your desires fulfilled. Is there any rule that a person must be a sannyasi to start chanting Bhagavan Nama? Is there any rule that only sannyasis must chant and grihasthashramis should not chant Bhagavan Nama? Definitely no. Jnaneshwar Bharat says, Asodi samsari jihve ve gukari. You can be in this materialistic world. Asodi samsari jihve ve gukari. You can be here, you can carry out your day-to-day activities, but still, you can do it as Krishnarpaniyam, Vithalarpaniyam, Pandurangarpaniyam. You can surrender yourself to him. Sarva dharman parityajya mam ekam sharanam vraja aham tva sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami mam shuchah. Leave all the dharmas aside and come to me. Fall at my feet. I will ensure that you get mukti, says Bhagavan. So all that we have to do is to divert all our activities towards Bhagavan. Even if we are engaged in day-to-day activities, people like us, we can still chant Hari Nama and Vithala Nama. One great example for this is Janabai. Janabai didn't want to leave Pandharipuram. She had visited Pandharipuram with her parents and she asked her parents to leave because she didn't want to leave Pandharipuram. So her parents had to leave her forcefully. After they left, this small girl was in the temple. Sant Namdev comes and he says, "Oh child, you cannot be here alone. I will take you with me." And from then on, she was the adopted sister of Sant Namdev. She engaged herself in all household activities. She would cook, she would clean, she would do all type of household activities. And if she gets up in the dawn, she will sleep only by midnight. That was her schedule. But still, she kept chanting Bhagavan Nama always. She couldn't stay away from Panduranga. Her dhyana, her mind was constantly fixed upon Panduranga. She kept chanting his names. When she cooked, she would say Vithala, 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 Vithala. When she cleans, she would say Vithala, 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 Vithala. When she does some other job, when she cleans the utensils, she would say Vithala, 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 Vithala. Everything was Vithala Maya for her. Everything in this world was only Vithala. But she didn't have time to go to Vithala's temple at all. Can Vithala accept this? Can he tolerate this? So he came running towards Janabai. Every day, he sat with Janabai and did all her household chores. He took up all her responsibilities. He cooked. He cleaned the house. He cleaned the utensils. He did everything for Janabai so that she didn't feel the pain of being separated from Panduranga. So she was happily living with Panduranga. And one day, to prove her greatness to this world, he leaves his harem in her house and comes back to the temple. Everyone finds out that Panduranga's harem necklace was found in Janabai's house. So they wanted to punish her. They kept her in an iron rod. They tied her up to an iron rod. They wanted to light it up so that she would be burnt into ashes. But to their surprise, the iron rod changed or got converted into a water fountain. Looking at this, they all understood that Panduranga visited Janabai and did this leela. Not only that, once Sat Namdeva visited the temple. He saw Panduranga hiding something behind him. He asked, "Oh Panduranga, what are you hiding?" He said, "I will not tell. Please do tell me, what are you hiding?" He said, "I am writing down Janabhai's abhangs. It had Janabhai Mane Deva, Janabhai Mane, Janabhai Mane, Janamane." So he kept writing down all those. Sat Namdeva laughed. For which Panduranga says, "Oh Sat Namdeva, you are laughing. You and other bhaktas will have so many opportunities to get along with the public and to sing all your abhangs. Many people might observe it, many people might write it down. There are many ways by which your abhang can be preserved. But who does Janabai have? She has none other than me. So I should only come to protect her. I will note down all her abhangams and I will give it to the world," says Panduranga. "Yoga kshemam vahamyaham." If we constantly think about him, if we say asoni samsari jihve vegukari, if we constantly divert all our activities towards him, he will come down, he will come to our place and he will help us. He will do all that we ask for and all that we don't ask for also, because he knows what is the best for us. So in the case of Janabai, Bhagavan took 100% responsibility and he gave yoga and kshema to Janabhai. So it is immaterial whether you are sannyasa ashram or grihastha ashram. All that is required, all that is important is constant chanting of Bhagavan Nama. Veda Shastra Ubhari Bahya Sada. Jnaneshwar Bharat says, Vedas and Shastras will embrace all those who sing Hari Nama always with open arms. It will protect all those bhaktas who sing Hari Nama always. Tukaram Maharaj was called a Jagat Guru. We say Jagat Guru Tukaram Maharaj. In his life, there was an instance where a person started chanting Jnaneshwari constantly to get Ashtamaha Siddhi, to attain great intellectual knowledge. He was staying in Anandapuri and he was chanting Jnaneshwari. Jnandev Maharaj came in his Swapna dream and said, "Oh, you great one, it is enough. Now you can go and meet Sant Tukaram Maharaj. He will direct you and he will give you all that you ask for." So this person got very happy. He comes to Devo and sees Tukaram Maharaj and he narrates all that happened. Tukaram Maharaj had tears in his eyes because he felt extremely blessed as Jnandev Maharaj had chosen him. So he said, "Definitely I will help you, Pa." Saying so, he took a piece of paper and wrote 11 shlokas, 11 vrittams in that, and he took a coconut and gave it to that person. He says, "You should only eat this coconut. Nobody else must eat it. You should only have it." He thought, "How can I get knowledge by eating coconut? Vedas and Shastras are like ocean. How can all of these be put in 11 shlokas? How can all of these be explained within 11 shlokas? It is highly impossible. This person is bluffing. This person is being illogical. So I will keep the paper and coconut here." Saying so, he silently left Tukaram Maharaj's house. He went out. Tukaram Maharaj smiles because this person is not blessed or he does not have the punya to get this. Thinking so, he He started his Nama Sankirtana and his daily routines. Same time, there was a minister in the Rajya Sabha who was not that very intelligent or clever and who didn't have good speaking skills. So he came to Tukaram Maharaj and said, "Oh Swami, please consider me to be a Shishya and teach me something which would make me better." So Guru Natha, Guru Kripa was there on that mantri, was there on that minister. So Tukaram Maharaj thought, this shloka and this coconut was kept aside for this minister and not for that person who had come earlier. Thinking so, he gave these to that minister and asked him to eat the coconut. He did eat it. He did chant 11 shlokas and he became very wise. Once upon a time, there was a pravachan arranged in the Rajya Sabha. A Pauranik had come to explain the Purana to all the ministers. They were all confused with one point. They didn't know what was the right answer. At that point of time, this minister, who was blessed by Tukaram Maharaj, gave the right answer and a logical reason for it. They were all spellbound. They were all surprised because he didn't know anything a few days back. But now he seems to explain Purana. How did you get this knowledge? He says, Tukaram Maharaj is the greatest guru. He is the Jagat Guru. He gave me this knowledge. Everyone was really angry at this because they had learnt Vedas and Shastras, but they were not able to solve something which this minister could do. This Tukaram Maharaj wouldn't have read the Vedas or the Shastras. He keeps singing, but is he able to solve all these things? Then we should definitely test him. Saying so, they all invite Tukaram Maharaj to the Rajya Sabha. After coming there, the Pauranika hands over the Purana to Tukaram Maharaj and says, "Will you be able to create a commentary, a Vyakhyanam for this?" He says, "Yes, I can." And he gives the Vyakhyanam in such a way that everyone was surprised and spellbound. It was given in a totally different way, but it had so much of deeper inner meaning in it. It was so pure. And then they understood that he had not gone to a school, he had not gone to a university, but Veda Shastra Ubhari Bahya Sada, the Nama Sankirtana which he did, gave him all the knowledge that he wanted. The Nama Sankirtana which he constantly clinged upon gave him all the knowledge and intellectual sthanam which he didn't even imagine about. So this is the greatness of Nama Sankirtana, says Jnaneshwar Maharaj. Finally he says, Jnanadeva Male Vyasachiya Kone. Do you think I'm telling all these because I have so much of time left with me? I have no other work. Do you think I'm telling all this without experience? If you think so, Vyasachiya Kone. I have a pramana for this, I have a proof for this. What is the proof? Go check the work which Vyasa has done. Mahabharatam. Vyasachiya Kone. Go check Mahabharatam. You will find that Lord Shri Krishna was the servant of Pandavas. Dwarakecha Rana Pandava Dhari. He was the Dwarakadhish. He was the king of Dwaraka, but still he always stayed in Pandava's house and kept protecting them from every single disaster that they faced. He was Partha Sarathi. He acted as the charioteer for Arjuna. He saved and protected Draupadi. He cleaned everything in Rajasuya Yajna. Everything, name anything, Bhagavan has done it. And why has he done it? Because Pandavas exhibited pure bhakti and devotion to Bhagavan. That is why Sant Purandara Dasa sings in a song.
Who vatai rovara vanege
Yeah.
is it illogical? If we look at it at a very shallow way, we might find it illogical. But the inner meaning in this is, Hova taruvara manage hulla taruvara. If we offer just the pushpam, just one flower to Bhagavan, he will become our servant. Tundarige tondaragi sancharisutiganu. He becomes our servant. He will do everything for us. He will get down to that level where he is also ready to take up grass and give it to us. Whenever required, he will also feed the cattle on our behalf. So he is such a compassionate Bhagavan. He is Bhakta Vatsala. If we give him flower, he will give us everything. This is just a comparison. To say, even if you give the most insignificant thing to him, he will give back the greatest thing to you. Ava Lakumi Ravana Ivagilla Garva. He is Lakumi Ravana. He is Lakshmi Ravana. He is the consort of Shri Mahalakshmi, who is the goddess of all wealth. What can you give him? Can you give him 1,000 kgs of gold? Can you give him 1,000 acres of land? Will he be happy by that? This entire world belongs to him. What can you give him? How can you please him by all these materialistic pleasures? But you can still bring him under your control by offering yourself. Ondu dale Shri Tulasi Bittu Gangodak Indira Ramanana Arpita Lennota. If you just offer one tulasi or one drop of water, one flower, it is enough. This is exactly the translation of the shloka that is found in Bhagavad Gita, where Bhagavan says, Patram pushpam phalam toyam yome bhaktya prayachati. Patram, just one leaf. Pushpam, just one flower. Phalam, just one fruit. Toyam, just one drop of water. Yome bhaktya prayachati. It might be the most insignificant offer to me, but if it's given out of bhakti, then it is the best gift for me. It is the best offering that you can give to me. All that you have to do is onde manadalli sindhu shayana mukunda yene yendettu vasitana mandirada olage. That Panduranga who stays in the temple, that Panduranga who stays in the mind, this temple called mind must always be thought about, must always be meditated upon. Onde manadalli sindhu shayana mukunda yene. We must keep thinking about him. We must keep thinking about his glory, his greatness and his leelas. He is so compassionate and he is so down to earth that Pandavara mane dolage kudurele ta toledo punneri kakshada in Pandava's house. He was the charioteer, so he had to take care of the horses. So he will go feed those horses. He came down to that extent where he fed the horses and took care of the horses, and he acted as the charioteer. What else do we need? Andajadhipa. He is the conqueror and the king of this entire world. Andaja Adhipa. He is the supreme power for this entire world. But for Pandavas to win this battle, he had come down as a charioteer, as Partha Sarathi. This is because he cannot see his Bhaktas facing a defeat. He will always be victorious and he will ensure that his Bhaktas get victory always. Yatah Krishnaha Tato Jayaha. Wherever Krishna is there, their victory only prevails. So to prove that, even though he is the Antajadhipa, he is the emperor of this entire world, he came down to help Pandavas as Tondarige Tondaragi. He came down as a servant to help Pandavas. This is the fruit that they have got for their bhakti. So a person through bhakti can control Bhagavan completely. Bhagavan himself says, अहम भक्त पराधीन अस्वतंत्र विजय People think that I am independent, but I am completely under the control of my bhaktas, says Bhagavan. Then why should we worry? Through our bhakti, we can capture Bhagavan and keep him within our controls. One such incident in Sant Tukaram Maharaj's story, life, was when Chhatrapati Shivaji had to stay in Tukaram Maharaj's house. Chhatrapati Shivaji was greatly attracted towards Tukaram Maharaj. He kept visiting him in different forms. He kept visiting Tukaram Maharaj and he wanted to offer something or the other to Tukaram Maharaj. So, one day, he brings gold, diamonds and jewelry. Looking at it, Tukaram Maharaj says, Do you know the conversation between Sita and Rama? Sita says there was a tapasvi who was indulged, who was constantly thinking about Bhagavan, who was meditating upon Bhagavan. But one fine day, Indra wanted to distract him. So he came in the form of a warrior and gave this tapasvi a sword, which was beautiful, which had stone studded and it was very precious. Having got that sword, this tapasvi's concentration was on the sword only, because this warrior had requested this tapasvi to take care of the sword until he returns. So this tapasvi started thinking about the sword only, because if he gets into deep meditation, then he will not be able to protect the sword. So he started thinking about the sword, and at one point of time, he started using the sword also, because there was no one who would come to claim the sword again. So he started using it. So his diversion, his mind got diverted from Bhagavan to sword. The sword cannot be compared to Bhagavan at all. But still, he was diverted totally. He was distracted totally. So in that way, Indra was able to successfully distract this tapasvi. Similarly, I am walking in the path of spirituality. I am going towards Bhagavan. Why are you bringing all these wealth to me? Why are you giving me all these jewels? These are of no use to me. Absolutely no use. Don't try to lure me with all these. I prefer chanting his namas and constantly thinking about him. After listening to this, Chhatrapati Shivaji wanted to learn more from Tukaram Maharaj and he stayed there for months together. This happened for many months and he constantly engaged himself in satsangam and nama sankirtana. One fine day on an Ekadashi, Aurangzeb found out that Chhatrapati Shivaji was in Tukaram Maharaj's place. So he sent about 2000 soldiers to capture Shivaji. Chhatrapati Shivaji didn't know about this. He was happily singing Bhagavan Nama. But the temple was surrounded by 2000 soldiers. Nobody knew what to do. At that point of time, Tukaram Maharaj says, Oh Panduranga, we are all singing your Nama. We are all deeply involved in your satsangam on an Ekadashi day. Why are you trying to distract our thoughts? Why are you trying to bring a problem for us? Please, immediately ensure that you sort this out. We don't want these problems when we are doing bhajans or nama sankirtan. Saying so, Tukaram Maharaj and everyone in the satsangam happily started singing Sundare Jaate Ubhari. Thank you.
Thank you.
am enjoying singing his namas in the satsanga. They didn't care about the soldiers. They didn't care about what was happening around them. Panduranga is tondarege tondarage. He comes down. He always wants his bhaktas to be happy. So he will also act as a sevaka, servant for his bhaktas. So immediately, he takes the form of Chhatrapati Shivaji and he leaves Tukara Maharaj's house on a horse. By saying this, all the soldiers started following him. They were all going into a deep forest and they all went too deep to that extent where even the moonlight didn't fall on the ground. So they all went too deep, and after taking them too deep into the forest, Panduranga disappeared. So ultimately, all the soldiers had to bump on each other, or they fell somewhere, they died out of hunger, or they were eaten up by wild animals, and ultimately, the entire set of soldiers, the entire army was destroyed by Panduranga. This was because Sant Tukaram had asked him to do it. Tukaram Maharaj had ordered Panduranga to do it, so he did it. So, for Panduranga, the foremost and most important responsibility is to take care of his bhaktas. Yoga Kshema Bahami Aham, he gives a signature and says, I am always bhakta paradhina and I always think about my bhaktas only. If they think about me constantly, I will take care of them. So the message from Yoga Kshema Bahami Aham is, let us stop worrying about petty things in life. Some things might come, some things might go. Let us try to accept everything as it is. This is very easy to tell, but very difficult to practice. But if we start practicing, through practice, everything is possible. When we start accepting happiness and sorrow equally, and when we start offering it to Bhagavan and telling him that it is all because of you and I give it to you, you take care of my life, he will take 100% responsibility of our life, like how a mother would take care of her newly born child. So let us try to give everything to Bhagavan, but let us not try to take it as an excuse from running away. Let us not say that I will not study, I will not get into satsangam also, but I want to pass. This is not possible. If you involve yourself 100% completely in Bhagavad Dhyanam and in Bhagavad Satsangam, he will take care of all your needs, whether it be spiritual or materialistic. So let us completely surrender at the holy feet of Panduranga. Let us always say to him that only because of him we are all living. And let us try to accept things as it is, and let us not run behind materialistic pleasures as they are all temporary and not permanent. Sarva sukhache adaru. Vittala is the reservoir of all happiness, and that happiness is eternal bliss. So let us start running behind eternal bliss, and ultimately let us start chanting his nama constantly, and by this let us all attain mukti and let us all attain him. Pandarinath Maharaj ki jai, Pandari Kshetra ki jai, Chandrabhaga Teerth ki jai, Samasta Bhakta Mandali ki jai, Samasta Sadhu Mandali ki jai, Samasta Sadguru Nath Maharaj ki jai. Hey.